Hello viewer, welcome to History and Government lesson, that is in Form 1, Lesson 7. I am your teacher, Mr. John Gatrin. In our previous lesson, we have been looking at the Chapter 2 on the early man, and we have been discussing the evolution process. We said on evolution process, evolution we defined as evolution is a process, is a slow or gradual process whereby man changes from a simple like creature to a more complex creature. I gave you some assignment that I want us to review today before we even start on the next topic today, on our lesson. So the question was, you explain why Africa is the most probable cradle of man. And the cradle of man, it means the origin. Why do you think Africa is the origin of man? There are various justification or reasons that tells or that explain Africa as the cradle of man. One, Africa has got numerous archaeological sites on the continent, and therefore this numerous archaeological sites, it proves that Africa was probable the origin or the cradle of mankind. Two, in Africa, there are the savanna grassland, and savanna grassland it provides a large area for hunting, and therefore a man could hunt and gather food in the area. Three, in Africa, there is usually a tropical climate, and this tropical climate is characterized by warmth, and therefore this one was more suitable for man. Three, and maybe the last one, in Africa, Africa presentation was a center of Pangaea, which enabled all early creatures to move to other regions during the continental drift. Therefore, when the earth was tilting, these creatures could move to other regions. The second question is, state two major reasons why early mammals lived on trees. Why do you think early mammals lived on the tree? And the early mammal lived on the tree because in the tree for the security reason, because on top of the tree it could spot the enemies from far. Therefore, this one was the main reason. Two, on top of the tree there were some fruits, and therefore because man could get these fruits through gathering, so this one suited man. In today's lesson, we shall continue on the early man. That is a chapter 2, and the subtopic that we are going to deal with in this particular lesson is stages through which man evolved. What are the stages through which man evolved? And these stages, we want to start with non-homo or the apes. We want to start with the non-homo or the apes. Remember, on this process of evolution, we said that initially man shared the same ancestry, and this is known as the primates. We said we have an ape-like creature, and we also have man-like creature. So we will start, for you to understand these stages, let us start with non-homo apes. And therefore, stages of non-homo apes or stages of evolution. Remember, looking at this picture, this approach, you will see the presentation of the stages of evolution. Right from the Priapithecus, Proconsul, Dryopithecus, naming the Oropithecus, Ramapithecus, Australopithecus, and then we have advanced Australopithecus, Homo erectus, early Homo sapiens, the Rhodesian man, Neanderthal man, Cro-Magnon, Homo sapiens. This is the stages of evolution. But we shall look at the non-homo. We shall look at the non-homo. And when we say non-homo, is that stages of development from, we shall start with the Dryopithecus all the way to Australopithecus. So welcome. So looking at the stages through which man evolved through various stages, and the stages number one started with Argyropithecus. It started with Argyropithecus. Who is this Argyropithecus? As the name suggests, Argyropithecus, coming from the word Egypt. So this means is an Egyptian monkey. Is an Egyptian monkey. Remember, we are looking at non-homo or apes like creature. So Argyropithecus is an Egyptian monkey. So it was discovered by A. Simon in 1965 in Fayum province. And Fayum is in Egypt. You can look at Argyropithecus in pictures together with its skull. So that means Argyropithecus took the form of an ape. It was not developed. It was not developed like the homo. But this is a non-homo. It's an ape-like creature. So exploring at its characteristics. What are the characteristics or features that you can see in this species, Argyropithecus? One, remember it was founded in Fayum Depression, that is in Egypt. Two, this species, Argyropithecus, is 4 kg in weight. The weight of this is 4 kg. It also lived about 30 million years ago. It had a tail. You saw the picture, it had a tail. It walked on four limbs. It walked on four limbs. So that means it had used the hands and the feet. That is the four limbs. It had that two teeth, just like the human being. It had that two teeth. It had an enclosed eye socket. Looking at the skull, you will see the enclosed eye socket. It had a stereoscopic vision, or rather the sharp vision. It could see from far. Because of an eye socket, the eyes could, it was sharp, it had a sharp vision. It lived in the forest, or looked like a monkey. That's why we say this is an Egyptian monkey. It looked like a monkey and therefore lived in the forest. We shall look at the second species in non-homo or apes. We have Dryopithecus africanus. Dryopithecus africanus, it is also known as the proconsul. The proconsul, as the name suggests, africanus. This was discovered in France in 1856 and also in Musinga Island in Lake Victoria. That's why we are giving it the name Africanus, Dryopithecus africanus, because it was discovered in Singa Island, that is in Ethiopia. This is a picture of Dryopithecus, and as the name suggests, it is not a homo. It is still non-homo or the ape. The physical characteristic is that of the ape, and we have discussed the Argyropithecus. So this is just a slight improvement as far as the physical features is concerned. Looking at its skull, you can see the features that is there in this Dryopithecus. Therefore, we will look at the characteristic of Dryopithecus. Some of the characteristic of Dryopithecus is it was small in size. It was small in size and looked like a chimpanzee. This one was very small in size and looked like a chimpanzee. You have seen the picture. It was very small. Two, it walked on four limbs. It walked on four limbs. When we mean four limbs, it could use both hands and also the feet. Three, it lived between a period between 20 to 25 million years ago. 20, 25 million ago. Fourth, this species, Dryopithecus, was about 4 feet long. The size of this species was about 4 feet long. It also had long teeth. The teeth were long. It had a smooth forehead. Those are the characteristics of the Dryopithecus africanus or proconsul. That one being the second, let us see the third. The third, we have the Ramapithecus. Ramapithecus is the third. And Ramapithecus is also known as the Kenya Pithecus or the woodland ape. This was discovered by the Louis Leakey in the year 1961 at a site called the Fort Tenan, that is in Kenya. So as the name suggests, Kenya Pithecus, it is an animal or a species that was discovered in Kenya. And in Kenya, that is in Fort Tenan, Fort Tenan is on the north part of Kenya, and it is also known as the woodland, and because these are live in the forest, it can live in the forest. That is the Ramapithecus. It was the third species in that order of evolution. And this animal or this species lived between the year 12 to 14 million years ago. MYA means millions years ago. And Ramapithecus, to come demonstrate the Ramapithecus in these pictures, this is the Ramapithecus. And Ramapithecus, looking like it is an ape, is not yet developed into a homo, and therefore it lived for a period between 12 to 14 million years ago. Looking at the skull, you can see the skulls, the jaw, you can see the jaw, the socket of the eye. The head also vision. So we will look at the features. The features or the characteristics of Ramapithecus are, one, it was small in size and looked like a chimpanzee. You have seen in the picture, it looked like a chimpanzee. Two, it had a brain size of 400 cc, that is the cranium capacity. The cranium capacity, this is the brain, the size of the brain. So this means it could think, unlike the former species, that is the Triopithecus and the Egyptopithecus. Three, it had a massive jaw. You have seen in the skull, it had a massive jaw. The jaw, it was very big. It also walked occasionally on two legs. Because it was a chimpanzee, it looked like a chimpanzee. It could occasionally walk on two legs, unlike the former species we have discussed, it walked with four. But this one occasionally, although it was walking on four, occasionally it could use two. Next, it had that two teeth and a smaller canine than earlier apes. Comparing these with the other apes, it had that two teeth and also the canine was a bit smaller compared to others. The reason why we are saying canine could be used to tear meat. Another characteristic, it had a weight between 18 to 36. It had a weight between 18 to 36. Lastly, it lived in an open savanna. Remember, in Africa, there was a savanna grassland, and this savanna grassland, it provided space for animal to hunt and gather. So this animal lived in savanna, and its skull and its fossil has been discovered in savanna area in Africa. Therefore, Africa is the cradle of the species. We have the fourth species, and this species we have Australopithecus. Australopithecus, it is also known as the Zingandropus, which means the southern ape. Zingandropus, coming from the word zinj. Zinj means an ape. This one came from the southern ape, known as the south coast, southern side. So it was the first, it was first discovered in Taung, that is in Botswana, in 1924. As the name suggests, we have said southern ape. It was discovered in the southern part of Africa. The southern part of Africa, this is in Botswana, a place or archaeological site that is known as the Taung. Taung being in Botswana, it was discovered in the year 1924. It was a long, long time ago. This species was founded by Dr. Louis and Mary Ricky at Odvai Gorge. It was also discovered by Dr. Louis Ricky and Mary Ricky at Odvai Gorge, that is in 1959, and also at Lake Turkana in 1969. So remember, Dr. Louis and Mary Ricky was one of the archaeologists who they were working in Kenya. And therefore in Odvai Gorge, 1959, they found or discovered the skull belonged to Australopithecus. So this species, it lived between the year 1 to 7 million years ago. It lived between 1 to 7 million years ago. Looking at the demonstration of Australopithecus and his skull, you can see Australopithecus sometimes, occasionally, we have said that it could also move on two limbs. This is an Australopithecus, a female species of Australopithecus. It could use occasionally to feed two limbs. The skull, looking at the skull of this that was discovered by the archaeologists, so we can have some characteristics of Australopithecus. Some of the characteristics of Australopithecus are, it had a brain size of 450 to 550 cranium capacity or CC. That means there is an advancement as far as this species development is concerned. And therefore, the brain size was growing even more higher compared to the former. Two, it had a hairy body. It had a hairy body, that one we have seen in the picture of Australopithecus. It had a hairy body, short and strong. It was short and strong. And the reason why it had a hairy body, remember these species mostly lived in the savannah. And therefore, some places where it lived, it was so cold. And sometimes this hair body could provide warmth. It also had short, it was short in size and strong. We have seen in the picture, and it was 1.5 meters long. It also had a massive jaw. Looking at its scar, you have seen a massive jaw with large molar and small canine. It had a large jaws with large molars and a smaller canine. It walked on two legs. I've seen it walked on two legs. There is a development of the evolution. I've seen it now walking on two legs. It also had a long forehead and a deep eyes and a deep set eyes. The forehead was a bit low and also had a deep eye socket. It's known as a deep eye socket. So that means its vision was very high and it could see from far. So it had a sharp vision. The vision of this was very sharp because of the eye socket. This gave him the characteristic of having a sharp vision. Lastly, it was made and also used some tools. The tools that he used was known as the Oldowan tool. Oldowan tool. They also used the Oldowan tools. It's a development because of the brain capacity of 450 to 550 cranium capacity. It could have an idea of making tools and also. So, to this, we shall stop here in this lesson. And, before we conclude, I want to give you some assignment that you will try so that in the next lesson we shall start from here. So you attempt this question: what does the term Zinjanthropus means? What does the term Zinjanthropus means? Question I want you to try. And how can you contact us? If you have a question, you have your question, you can get us through the Facebook page, that is Elimu TV. Our Twitter handle is Elimu_KE. So I'm so glad you are watching Elimu TV. This is your TV station where you watch and learn. Stay tuned until we meet in the next lesson. I have been your teacher, Mr. John Tuma.